All right, guys, I don't know if this is going to be a standalone video or if this is going to work itself into the tune-up, but I said during my tune-up video I wasn't going to mess around with this throttle body because I didn't have gaskets for it, but I did a parts run. So here is what it looks like behind a throttle body after 30 years of never being removed. Now, this throttle body almost didn't want to come off. It was actually hanging up on this bolt. Yeah, pretty filthy. I'll show you inside the throttle body here. Check this mess out. So how this all came to be is I was having just a little bit of an idle issue. Not much, but it kind of, the car would fall on its face every once in a while right after I started it. And I thought, well, could be a vacuum leak. These small block Fords are known for, are notorious for vacuum leaks. But I thought maybe it's that idle air bypass in the throttle body. So I thought, well, couple gaskets, right? They're pretty cheap. I'm gonna check it all out. And anyway, I find this hot tarry mess behind there. So glad I did it when I did. Because yeah, I mean, the throttle body almost didn't want to come off the plenum. It was on there so tight. So anyway, I'm gonna get after cleaning all of this stuff up and see if this solves my problem. If it doesn't, I very well may be hooking the smoke machine up to this and seeing if I got a vacuum leak. But it's not awful. Like, typically when that idle air bypass is dirty, you'll have really erratic idle. I mean, you'll hit 3 grand down to 1,000, it'll fall on its face, it'll be all over the place. I'm not really dealing with that. It's just, it almost seems like it's a vacuum situation, but anyway, this is cheap insurance and I wanted to clean this throttle body up regardless, so here I am. Anyway, I'm gonna tear this guy, well, it's more or less tore down. I'm just gonna clean it up, hit it with some carb cleaner, sensor cleaner, and put her back together and get it back in there. So anyway, stand by. Right, so throttle body is cleaned up. No more carbon garbage. Idle air bypass, got that all tidied, got the new gasket for it. Now I ended up taking off my EGR because I wanted to make sure that it actually still opened and closed. So my coupe had, it was carboned right up and wasn't opening and closing, and I ended up having like a bit of a vacuum leak in the back end of this thing, so wanted to make sure that wasn't the case with this. Anyway, got it off of there and cleaned it up. Now I've also tidied everything up here. You can see I've got the gasket on there already, but yeah, everything's gonna start going back together here now. Pretty simple removal and install. I mean, it's by no means rocket science or anything. Just take note of what you're peeling off, and like I say, I mean, it's for the price of this gasket, if you've never taken yours off or you haven't in a very long time, it might not be a bad thing to remove, because like I said, this bolt, and these are kind of well, they're threaded in to the plenum here. You can actually, the bolt will pile up on this, or the nut will pile up on this bolt and back out. You can all, I don't know if you can see or not, but like, even the threads are pretty beat up. Now I ran a quick thread cleaner over there just to tidy them up a little bit. Yeah, they're pretty beat up because this is a coolant line, right, that runs through this EGR spacer. I don't know if coolant, yeah, it must seep down in there a little bit or whatever. So anyway, yeah, gonna get this back together and hope that I got a little bit better idle. If not, just one more thing to sleep a little bit better at night and know that it's cleaned up. Back together. got some clips put back in there that weren't previously in there. And anyway, and here's my air box out of my old coupe. Looks a little better in there. Anyway, we'll fire it up and see what we're dealing with. Okay, guys, we're gonna jump in, do a true cold start, and see how she runs after the throttle body overhaul. So far, so good. Let it idle down here a little bit. Well, that's a heck of a lot better than what it was before, I'll tell you that much. Yeah, that fixed it. Now, just to give you a sense of what it was doing before, it was like, it wasn't jumping all over the place, but it seemed like it was hunting as to where it wanted to idle. And, well, I cleaned everything, as you saw, inside of this throttle body, including the idle air bypass. Yeah. Essentially just a good old-fashioned cleaning and some new gaskets, which, heck, I could have been leaking air past, whatever. There's so many things that can go sideways when you're looking for idle issues. 9 times out of 10 with these Fox bodies, it's vacuum related, but this throttle body can give you some grief too. So just word to the wise, don't underestimate getting yourself some gaskets, popping this guy off, and giving it a good old-fashioned cleaning, especially if you're unaware as to when it was last done. All right, guys, sorry, quick change of clothes here. Had to clean up after this tune-up day. Yeah, so I'm gonna be honest with you here. I'm gonna lean towards the 51% side of things and say that I lucked out in this being my issue. Maybe that's the wrong way of saying it. I just don't want to lead you astray and say that cleaning your throttle body and your idle air bypass and all that, like I just did, is going to fix all of your idle problems. It will and it won't, okay? As I mentioned, these Fox bodies are notorious for vacuum leaks, specifically associated around your intake. They have issues, okay? So that could be your issue as well. I don't wanna, you know, send you down a path and say that this is gonna fix your all of your idle issues, because it may not, but it may too, okay? And this is, other than your time and call it $25 or so in gaskets, it's not a bad maintenance item to look at. And then at the very least, you can cross that off your list of things that could be an issue, right? So yeah, it's not a bad thing to clean, okay? Get all the carbony black gum out of there, and just know in your head when you're driving down the road, if you have an issue, it's probably not coming from there anymore, because you've already done that and tended to it, okay? But in my case, it fixed my issue. This engine, to the best of my knowledge, is pretty solid and tight as far as leaks are concerned. I've yet to notice anything in all the horsing around that I've done with it. So I was pretty confident in leaning towards this being something associated with that throttle body area. And yeah, as you can tell, it's running great now. So I wished I would have had a video of it running weird before, but it was kind of doing it sporadically too. So chances are if I tried to film it, it wouldn't do it. It was one of those every so often situations. But yeah, that's that. So I hope this helps some of you guys out there. By all means, if you got any questions, chances are I screwed something up in here as I'm explaining it. So reach out, as most of you know that have commented or reached out to me via email or whatever. I'm more than willing to get back to you. I love talking these cars and helping people out, guys. So please hit me up if you need a hand. Anyway, that's going to do it for this one. So thanks for tagging along, guys. I'll catch you on the next one. Take care. Bye for now.